Wait, I want to know about what you found. $20 each.
I recognize that guy anywhere.
Oh, look at him. Terrifying. Or charming.
Run! Go! Go!
I'm so happy I came back to the
hold on.
No, show me.
You gotta leave some things for the haul. Stay to the end and you'll see everything.
Wow!
Thank you to everyone who has purchased recently. We are dropping everything off.
Yep, we are dropping off some of the shipments that we have, and then we are heading out maybe to some thrift stores, maybe to some estate sales. It's a rainy day out. Sort of gross, but we will make the best of it. And if you guys didn't know, we actually have a P.O. box. $8.55 right here. And if you guys are interested in sending us anything, a letter, a package,
then I will put a little address here for where you can send any letters or mail to.
Further south in Jersey today, and there's actually quite a few Goodwills over here. So hopefully these Goodwills have something.
Seems like the place to be today.
It does, there's a lot of cars here, so we're gonna go inside and hope we strike gold.
It looks like a packed Goodwill. It's like a lot of stuff here, looks like.
Did you find anything? Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Piggy bank.
I found a Hazel Atlas jar gun.
Oh, yeah,
but it has some wear on it. This is like the second or third one I found. $2.99. It's not bad. There's two. Double turtles.
Like this pig.
But is it big enough?
I don't know. Because I do really want like a
substantial piggy bank.
He's so cute. I don't think I'm gonna leave him.
Okay. Hey! Oh my god, I had that one.
Yeah?
With the holographic cover.
I wanted to see what year it was from. The yellowing makes me feel...
Oh yeah, that's from like 99. 97 maybe.
96?
Yep, 96.
Hey, look, it's never even been cracked.
Wow. That's a great find. Yeah. Also, 6-year-old Laura would have loved this.
Oh my god, so cute. Is that Precious Moments?
I don't know what it is. Could you peel that up for me? Made in Korea.
Special people?
1985 Hasbro. Wedding. Is this My Little Ponies?
Ooh.
Had to search that.
How cute.
This little planter with a bunny, a cat, and a dog. And it's a Ralpo for $4. This is a really fun find. Because it's made in Japan, this is probably from the 60s. It's so cute and kitschy. Oh my goodness. Usually when I find these block ones, they're not as cute. I'm gonna have to get this.
Hey.
Hi.
I found a, it's $9.99. I gotta see what colors are on. But I can tell you, I recognize that guy anywhere.
Oh, look at him.
But it's $10.
$10 is a lot.
Yeah.
Look what I found.
Oh wow. Ralpo.
Yeah, it's a good one. Nice. Look at how cute.
That's so cute. Not bunny.
I know. It's really cute. And it's only $4.
Goosebumps? Goosebumps?
Oh look, it's a Wendy.
What?
Wendy.
Oh.
I'm like trying to hope
Casper?
Fingers crossed
Casper?
This Casper. Yes. Okay. Hold on. Oh boy. Okay. Kind of freaking out. There's so many. Got this one. Not in as good condition. My god. I'm finding so many Goosebumps. Ooh. Look at that guy. Oh my god, look at all these. So many Goosebumps.
These mugs are fun. Flick gut, flick pike. I don't know what that means, but I do like the little dogs and cats on there. And they're $1.99 each, and they're marked Original Bohemia. I think they did a lot of floral mugs, but I've never seen these before. A vintage Nala for $3. Let's see if we can get a year on the tag. Ah, from Disneyland. Let's see. Yeah, Disneyland, product of China, so it's probably from the 90s. That's pretty cool to see. Goosebumps?
They're all Goosebumps.
They're in better condition than the ones that you found here last time.
Yeah. I'm looking at them all. I haven't even looked at them.
Wow. I found, I don't know if you know anything about these, but Magic the Gathering.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know anything about them, but I found a few cards for
$3. $20, I thought you said.
Oh, no. They're only $3.
Yeah, I don't know any about that.
Okay.
These ones are 2015. I don't know.
Yeah, not my forte. Teletubbies, $20 each. These are from like the early 2000s. My cousins had these. Can you believe they're $20 each? That's a little crazy, no? They're all here though. Look, all of them.
I had to come back to the books, and I'm so glad I did. Look at this Arthur's Halloween book. I've never seen this before. I'm so excited. Look how cool it is. Look at the back. 99 cents. Awesome.
What's that?
Look at this. Abraham Lincoln joke book. What? I'm so happy I came back to the books.
Why? What'd you find?
I found like my one of my coolest books yet.
Do you show?
There's lots of books which are really cool. These two. But don't look.
What?
Don't look. Look.
Wow.
Oh, this Halloween. Look at the back of this.
Wow.
I didn't even look at it. I was just like, oh my god. So cool.
Copyright?
It should be the 70s. Probably 82.
Wow. That's such a good find, Jeannine. Arthur Halloween.
Look at that.
Oh, that's so fun. Oh my gosh.
This is like in the collection. Instant, like right on the shelf.
Yay!
So cool. And I found two more. I found this one, which is really cool, and it looks like, you know, modern, right?
Uh-huh.
It's really modern.
Oh yeah, no.
It's another weekly reader book. 72.
Wow, look at those mushrooms.
Look at this. Illustrations are incredible.
Wow.
And then I found
fun.
I probably won't get this one. It's Halloween with Morris and Boris.
Okay.
But yeah. I'm not crazy about moose around here, so put that one back. I got this one, which is the Headless Horseman.
Oh, cool.
Sleepy Hollow.
That's older,
never
too.
Never seen this one before. Like this.
That cover?
This, yeah. 1970. And look at that.
Very cool.
So exciting.
Wow, you found a lot of Halloween books.
I'm like buzzing.
Yeah. And do you have a stack of Goosebumps?
Yeah, these are...
They're like $2 each or so, right?
Yeah, it's gonna be like $30 in books.
Wow.
Things for the haul.
No, show me!
You gotta leave some things for the haul. Stay to the end and you'll see everything.
I wanna see it now! Wait, I wanna know about what you found. You're being very secretive about it.
Am I?
Yeah. What is this?
Walkie-talkies.
Walkie-talkies?
I'm full of mystery.
You are.
Power on.
Oh my god, it's so loud.
So, I've always wanted walkie-talkies. Like, I had like kid ones when I was younger, you know?
Wait, is this for us when we're in the thrift store and we can like walkie-talkie each other?
For us.
At an estate sale? Like, Jeannine, giant blow molds in the basement.
But you know what I was thinking? It's like, if we get separated, from each other at a flea market.
Where there's no like cell service.
I gotta figure out how to use these, but okay. So I'll be over here.
Can you read me, Laura?
I read you copy. Is that what I say?
I don't think you pressed the right button.
Copy. This is so hard.
Are you pressing the button?
The mic or the mic? Copy?
Maybe yours is broken.
Oh no, wait. Copy. Copy? Hello?
I can hear you, copy.
Oh, I got it. Okay, so like we're at like an estate sale and I'm like, Jeannine, down in the basement, whole towers. Do you copy?
Copy. Coming on up. I could be like, Laura, I'm at Unique. Aisle 4. Blow molds. Copy?
I'm like, Roger that.
Laura.
Wait, repeat that. I was pressing down the mic.
Laura. Laura. 10 o'clock, pumpkin pail.
I'm like, run, go, go, go.
These are so fun.
Laura?
Yes?
These are so much fun.
Copy, I'm standing right next to you.
This is how we're gonna talk for the rest of our lives.
We just use them in the house. No pumpkin left behind, copy?
Copy, on pumpkin patrol.
What? Jeannine, I don't think we can wait for the haul.
No, I don't think so. I gotta just talk about this really quick. So, I know a little bit about vintage hats, and I like to sell them. Sometimes I like to wear them. But I got this really cool vintage Sports Specialties, which is the tag, is the brand that you want to look out for when you're looking at vintage hats. So, this Giants hat. And I just looked on eBay. It's a little dirty, but like I can clean it up. This hat sells for over $100. This one, the best offer was accepted. They tried to sell it for like $250, but this is just wild.
Oh my god!
We have new colors out today at Unique.
Yellow, orange, blue, yob.
Yellow, orange, blue, yob. Yellow, orange, blue. Terrifying or charming? I have to say terrifying, like 1000% terrifying. $10 each. No, thank you. How cute are these guys? Little owl Santa salt and peppers. These have a bisque finish, which means they're matte looking. See, compared to something like this, that's shiny. So that means that they're probably from like the 80s, but they're really cute. Kitschy. Oh look, they're actually Joseph originals. So that's even better. So we're gonna definitely get these. And they're $3, 25% off. What'd she find? Mickey. Fun.
It's all ripped up though, so I don't know if it was like from the parks or not.
Oh. It's cute though.
Then I found.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if I'm gonna get it, but it's the Northwest Company.
Is that the company to look out for these types of things?
I think so.
Yeah?
I think so. I'm not 100% sure. But look at it. It's Sesame Street.
Oh, wow. It's really cute. Yeah.
So
that's fun.
Yeah, it's only $7.99 and it's yellow, so
That means it's $6.
Yeah, so I might think about it. It's in pretty good condition.
Yeah, it is. I like it. This, like, old fabric. I don't know why I love that's it so cute. Much. I know. It's pretty like thick too. I wonder if it's I remember last time in one of our estate sale videos, I passed up on like really thick fabric that people called
bark cloth,
something like that. And it's upholstery. And apparently people are saying it's worth a lot.
I don't know.
I don't know about this one, but isn't it fun?
Yeah. Maybe ask the Instagram friends.
Maybe I will ask the Instagram friends. Oh, that's just so fun.
So I did find this big box computer game from the 90s. I think it's 94 or 95. And sometimes these can be worth a lot of money. This one, unfortunately, is not, especially being like $5 because it's 50% off. There's like two listed for 20. And the ones that have sold have been completely sealed. So I'm gonna have to pass on this, but really cool. It's hard to find like old media like this, especially at our thrift stores, because they're easy to flip. A lot of people know about them, and yeah, so the thrift stores seem to know about it too, because it's $9.99.
It's a planter.
Ah, that's fun.
Which I think is really cool. You don't see that a lot, and it's from 1993. It's a Holland mold planter.
Ah.
I think I might pick it up.
Yeah, it's pretty cute. I like it.
Halloween sale.
Yeah.
If anyone's interested in this.
I like the little witch coming out of the top.
Yeah, and the little pumpkin peeking out.
That's cute.
Because, you know, no pumpkin left behind.
This is a reproduction Hallmark, but I thought it was really cute. But look what I just spotted here.
What?
Little Corral cups. I doubt they're worth too much. $2 each. Fun.
Where? Another Santa mug?
It's a pretty good, like the glaze looks vintage, but it is definitely newer. Chalkware clowns, made in Taiwan from the 70s. Why were clowns such a thing in the 70s?
So I found a bunch of books, some pretty cool ones to add to my Halloween book collection. I found this one. This one's really cool. I've never heard of it before. The Pumpkin Smasher. It has amazing illustrations inside. It is so cool, and I'm so happy to add that to the collection.
Cool.
Another Headless Horseman, a Sleepy Hollow book to add. This one is also really cool. The illustrations inside I thought were very interesting and eye-catching, which is something that I like to add to my collection. This was probably my most exciting find.
This was amazing.
I loved finding this Arthur book. It's from 1982. I have never owned Arthur's Halloween before, and I love the cover art. The illustration is beautiful in this. Look at the back. I have to take this sticker off very carefully.
It's only 99 cents.
It was only 99 cents. It was a great, great buy, in my opinion. And it just has, like, classic Arthur illustrations.
Classic.
I love it so much. These books are very interesting. I really don't know what to say about them. They're like books that go along with like a computer game, but like, yeah, it's interesting. It says the programs will run in BASIC on the IBM PC, PC Junior, Apple II, is that what it's called? So many like old computers. So I thought this was really cool. So I looked these up, and there's a series of them. So I have number 1 and number 3, and some of them sell, like, I saw one sold for like $20, $10. So I picked these two up, and I figure I'll put them up on eBay. They were just really cool. Especially this one, I thought had a really fun cover. And yeah, if anyone has ever played these, let me know. I'm so curious to know how you would have played these. I found a huge lot of Goosebumps books, and they are in great condition. Hardly ever read. Like, the spines are like, I don't know, like, have the books ever been cracked? I don't really know. They're all from the 90s, like, first printing. Amazing. So nostalgic for us, right, Laura? You said you read like the ones.
I had so many. I wish I kept them. I had dozens.
With the holographic cover, right?
Yep.
So these are really exciting, and they're fun, and I will probably hold on to them till I have like a huge, huge lot of them to put up on eBay. I'm collecting very little Goosebumps books because, well, I already collect so many Halloween books.
I think the holographic ones, if I remember correctly, are these the Choose Your Own Adventure?
Yes.
Oh, so good.
Maybe we'll have to read them before.
Just look at some of these graphics.
I know, look at this one.
Oh my gosh, that is so fun.
Yeah, so these are fun and great, you know, great to put in displays and stuff like that. So hats. Hats can be worth a lot of money. I am so surprised at the value of this one. I know, like, you know, like I said in the car, I like to buy hats, sell hats, and wear hats. So I saw these. They were, to me, they were like, oh, those are a little expensive, but I'm gonna buy them. This one was $4.99. This one was $5.99. So I paid up a little bit, but that is so worth it, especially for this one. But I'll talk about this one first. So what caught my eye about this hat was the cool all over graphic of it. There is so much to it. It's in pretty decent shape. I felt it, and it felt like wool. So I turned it over, and I did see that it's American Needle, which is a pretty decent hat brand, vintage 90s hat brand to sell. There's a couple condition issues, maybe some wool, one of those like moths or something, wool. Has a couple little tiny holes here, but I don't think that will affect the value of it too much. This hat will probably sell for maybe like $25. Still even has the cardboard insert there.
Yeah.
So someone really loved this hat and took decent care of it. But what's really amazing is the other hat. So this hat, I was so surprised. It sells for over like $100 to $150 on eBay.
Wow.
It is a vintage 90s Giants hat. It is made by the brand Sports Specialties, which is a good hat brand to look for. I did notice that it was Sports Specialties in the store, but I didn't think it was going to go for as much as it does. So I'm really excited to sell this. I'm excited to put this on eBay. I'm excited to clean it up because it is a little dusty. And
what a good find, Jeannine.
An amazing find. Yeah, it turned $5 into hopefully over $150.
Do you have any insight as to why? This one to me seems like simpler, but it goes for more.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's just the brand.
Mm.
It is the Sports Specialties.
Crazy.
Made in Korea. Amazing.
Amazing. Great find.
Thanks.
Talk about like 80s, 90s finds. Jeannine found the Goosebumps, and I want to talk to you guys about my favorite find of today. It is this vintage ceramic. I know in the thrift store, I wasn't too sure, but after I looked at it even more in the thrift store, I was like, this has to be My Little Pony. And if you flip it over, there is a Hasbro marking. It doesn't say My Little Pony, but this is a 1985 My Little Pony ceramic.
Wow.
And I did some research, and these are quite collectible. My Little Pony came out with a few, not a lot, but a few ceramics made by this company, Extra Special, like some random company that probably produced these ceramics for card shops and such. But there is a number of ceramic figurines. The most common is like a single pony, and there are some really elaborate ones that sell for over $100, $200.
That's amazing.
I didn't know that these existed. This one is called Wedding Prance, and it's two little ponies getting married.
Wow.
I love these. I loved My Little Pony. I was a Generation 2 girl back in the 90s. This is Generation 1, so 1985. It's quite amazing. It definitely has a great resale value. I might have to hold on for it for a little bit. So this is just something new that I learned about and something to keep your eye out if you're at the thrift store. It's bisque, which we talk a lot about, and we usually say bisque is newer, so it's not as good, but this is a totally different market. This is My Little Pony, so this is definitely very collectible. I also found this vintage baby planter. Now, when you look out for baby planters, a lot of the time you find this block style, but not so often do you find it with these adorable little characters on it. And that's what makes this pretty collectible. Very kitschy. Somebody who likes to collect baby planters would definitely like this in their collection. And another brand to look out for when looking at planters is Relpo. Relpo made some of the cutest, in my opinion, baby planters in the mid-century. They are made in Japan, and a lot of the time the Relpo planters have these really cute characters. So this is something that I might have to hold on to again. I'm looking for a pen holder, so this might have to be it.
That's a lot of pens.
It's going to take me a while to fill up, and then maybe I'll pass it along. But I love this dog. That's my favorite one. I did end up purchasing this fabric, which I do believe is bark cloth. If you take a close look, Jeannine, you can see a texture on it. Do you see those like lines?
Yeah.
That is what I believe gives it the name bark cloth. I did a little bit of research at the thrift store.
Really?
I'm like 80% sure that this is vintage, probably from the 70s by the look of it. It is really pretty. It has these great florals, very like mod, right? So this is available on my eBay if you guys are interested. I will throw up the dimensions and everything on there. It's pretty big. Wow, and it'd be really fun to make like a dress or a tote bag or something fun and summery out of this.
Or like cushions for your table or something.
I also like the black and like the fluorescence. It's pretty different too. I was really excited to find these salt and pepper shakers of these adorable little owls.
You know, I didn't realize they had the SNP on them.
They do, right on their little bellies.
Yeah.
Really cute that they're wearing Santa hats. They are bisque. Well, they're actually not quite bisque. They have a matte finish.
Yeah, they have a little bit of like a satin.
Yeah, that's a great way to describe it. And they are actually Joseph's, and it has that little sticker right there.
You know, I find that a lot with Joseph's. They have that like more satin type finish rather than a
true bisque.
Or no, like even a true like shiny ceramic.
Yeah, there's like really shiny ceramics, which are like Napco's, Lefton, true mid-centuries. There are sort of a satin sheen, which Joseph did. I think Napco did some of that too. Like those cat planters I sold have that satin sheen.
Yeah.
And then you have true bisque ceramics, which are really like almost
rough to the touch.
Yeah, like eggshell almost.
Yeah, and they're from like the true 80s and 70s. So these are probably made in Japan. They're probably from the 60s if I had to guess.
Yeah, definitely with those like flower type eyes.
Yeah, they're really cute. There is a little bit of red paint loss that we talk about when you do identify vintage ceramics to look out for. It's an indicator, but it doesn't definitely mean that you have a vintage piece on your hands. And yeah, I'm just really excited about these. I've never come across them before. I'm going to hold on to these until we do a holiday sale. We like to hold on to our Christmas and Halloween things that we find throughout the year and do big holiday sales. And if you guys are interested in those sales, make sure you're following us here on YouTube and also on our Instagram, Shiny Brite Doggo. These two places is where we announce all of our holiday sale information. But how cute are they?
I love them.
I was so excited. As always, thank you guys so much for joining us in another thrifting adventure. We're so happy you joined us. We're excited about those walkie-talkies too. We gotta get over to a flea market so we could put them to use.
Yeah, test them out.
If you guys are enjoying our videos, we'd super appreciate it if you subscribe to our channel and hit that like button below. Really helps us out in a really simple way. Thanks for joining us, guys.
See you next time.
Bye. Bye.